This is Keepsakes, the podcast. I'm Jay Agonoy. It's the 81st episode of the podcast. Thank you very much for joining us right here on this special occasion. Pamberte nyo na sa akin tong lahat to, all of you guests here. Below me is Jay Melegrito, anime Pilipinas.
Your boy is here!
Your boy!
Boy!
Ayan, beside him is Kurumeme. Kurumeme does clips for some Niji Sanji personalities on YouTube on his spare time. Kurumeme, or should I call you Kurt? Ayan, so naputol uli siya. He'll be back later on. And Sky is with us, isa sa mga nakilala ko na he's doing this thing called the fake VTuber News PH. Pero magantabay kayo through the whole conversation. We'll be having some surprise announcements along the way. So, yeah, habang hinihintay natin si Kurumeme, let's go to JM. JM, first question, how did you get to VTubers?
Kung ako ang tatanungin, maybe about five months ago, wala akong magawa dito sa bahay. Of course, it's quarantine time.
Yes, all.
It's one of those things na nire-recommend ng YouTube kasi meron din ako mga kaibigan na nanonood na rin ng mga VTubers specifically sa Hololive. And then I saw that Pecora video about that surgeon video something and napanood ko and it all fell down the hole.
Oo. Went downhill. So I've never expected you of all the people to also fall in the VTuber rabbit hole. So it's a lesson din tong si YouTube eh. The last time that YouTube recommended us this music, that's not Mari Ijima. Si whoever that is, Plastic Love. Yeah, Plastic Love. So yeah, yan. Nagsimula dyan. And then Vaporwave ulit. So yeah. Lesson din po si YouTube. So YouTube is dependent on us na manonood. Right. Okay. Let's go to Sky. Sky, how did you get to VTubers?
All right. So how did I get into it? Or should I talk about how I discovered VTubers in the first place?
The latter.
The latter? Yeah. I'll start with the discovery of VTubers. So back then, what I call this, nanonood lang ng video dun sa YouTube. Since free time ko after ng school, yeah, I was just messing around with YouTube, annotating lang ko. Then, while I was watching the anime man's video, aka Joey, pinag-usapan niya yung isang VTuber na si Kizuna Ai na siya yung first VTuber na nakilala ko talaga through the anime man's video. And I think ang ganda talaga ng concept of a VTuber in virtual reality. And doon ako nag-start talaga kay Kizuna Ai. Ito naman talaga yung the year when I got into VTubers. Hindi lang sa isang VTuber. Which is Hololive. Sama ulit nagsimula noon, 2019. I think it was in March. Nung nakita ko yung compilation ni Shirakami Fubuki Noises. Sa Minecraft stream niya. Mm-hmm. And that's basically it. Yung isa pa nag-boost sa akin ay yung Shirakami Fubuki, I'm Scatman. Yung talaga yung...
Scatman. Oo.
I'm Scatman.
Pira-pa-para-po. Alam mo, the fun thing about that, so I also saw the Scatman video. Something like that. So that song was one of the hits, Europop hits at his time. That was 90s. Mga bago mag-millennium. In Nagoya, it was on the top charts, if I'm not mistaken. So parang, wow. Old soul din tong si Fubuki minsan. Right. Now, let's go to Kurt. Kurt, how did you get into VTubers? Last time nag-usap tayo, watagay-watagay ka lang. How did that happen? Ayun, he's still off. Kalma lang, data signal. I'll ask him to unmute. Yan. Yes, pre.
So, okay na.
Yeah.
Kizuna Ai. Tapos, yung gaming niya, Resident Evil ata yan.
Oo, uh-huh.
Resident 2018 or 2017. Hmm. Tapos, nag-stop din ang team. Yung kaibigan ko, best friend ko in real life.
Mm-hmm.
Nananood na lang. Ikaw naman yung nag-recommend sa akin ng VTuber. So, bakit ka nag-stop?
Mm.
Well, look where we are now.
Ba't ka daw nag-stop? So?
Oo.
Ayun, so,
wala eh, nag-idol. Pero, mm. Iba yun.
Oo. Idols, oo.
Iba yun eh.
Oo.
Pero, yun nga.
Mm. Sige, go, Kurt.
Okay na.
Ayun, okay na pala eh. Okay. Sige, yun nga. From idols, we went to virtual idols. Nagsawa na po tayo sa mga idols. Oh, nagsawa na ako sa MIT. I have to be open on that kasi open when I said that I will graduate from MNL Porte, tas graduated from the group. So, since we talk about VTubers, we'll do around ang discovery ka naman sa VTubers kasi is through through Kizuna Ai, Miraya Kari, I've seen those, pero Asa Coco sealed the deal. Asa Coco. Asa Coco sealed the deal. So, okay.
Drug dealer.
Wala pa nga ini-introduce si Coco na flute type Asa Coco eh. That would be whack. Flute type Asa Coco.
I've been... Sabi...
Lami flute na yan, oh.
Ayun na. So, moving on. Okay. I'll start with JM. JM, sinong pinipili mong panoorin na VTuber so far?
Ika nga sa idol culture, as if naman kailangan pa natin ano yung AKB48 na. I'm a subscriber of Korone. Yes, Pecora dragged me to the hole, but I stayed with Korone, especially na napanood ko yung Doug. Doug. Doug videos niya. that was an epic ride na nung napanood ko yung mga clips noon. Mm-hmm. And wow, Koran is certainly different from others from Hololive na mm-hmm. talagang she goes on her own pace, she goes on her own way. She would play Fall Guys, she would play the modern games, pero she would I kind of love watching her playing the Mario, Donkey Kong, Crash Bandicoot kasi yun yung nakalakihan ko eh.
Ah, I also grew up with Crash Bandicoot. Nilalaro ni kuya ko yan. Pero I stuck with CTR, Crash Team Racing. Kaya nga napunta din ako sa Crazy Kart eh. Alright, okay. So, for JM, it's Korone. Sky, VTuber mo.
Wait lang. Should I, Okay, let's start with...
Isa lang.
Fine. Share kami fubuki.
Okay, the Fox Burger King. Alright, why?
Right, the reason why, siya talaga yung what they call is I grew fond dun sa, auto-follow. Like, mm-hmm. I still watch her videos. I still remember that void, the stream, of her. Yeah, she did the recording herself, yung BGM. It turned out to be a hit. Like, what the heck was that? Yeah, I still visit her streams time by time, pero not all the time. Pero I still love it. Every time I visit her stream, talaga ma-enjoy ko talaga. Alam ko, she has something, she has, what they call this? She will bring something talaga dun sa, unique sa stream na yun. That's why, I grew fond of her.
All right. Okay. Kurt,
kung okay lang, I want to butt in. It's Sunday, so it's meme review.
Yeah.
Napakinggan ko si Fubuki, yung tawa niya. Oh my god, it's a blessing. I'm totally yes. blessed.
Indeed. I can feel it there though.
I also watched it earlier before lunch. Blessed. May announcement si Coco at that time, but we'll get to there. Kurt, sinong VTuber? Hello.
Isa lang talaga? Bakit isa lang?
Bakit?
Unless loyal,
Yung Yung latest or yung nag-stay talaga ako?
Oh, yung stay ka talaga.
Chigusa.
Chigusa. Ah, oo.
Chigusa na Chigusa.
Nijisanji. Ito yung bagong generation ng Nijisanji right now, no?
Yes.
Yung elementary tuloy. High school sila.
Ano, meron din silang ano, middle schooler.
Middle schooler, oh, middle schooler. Middle school yun, di ba, si Chigusa? Oh.
Hindi, high school si Chigusa.
Oh, nalito na ako, di ba?
Pero yun nga, sa kanya ako nag-stay because, you know, yung parang vibe ni Subaru.
Ah, okay.
Well, naging oshi ko din si Subaru, kaya yun. Nagustuhan ko si Chigusa because of yung utawa ko niya talaga. If you watch her utawa ko, ganda ng boses niya kapag kumakanta.
Mm-mm. Utawa ko meaning karaoke stream. All right. Sige, thank you for your choices ano, and I'm looking forward to ask you the same question again in the next few months kasi the VTuber of this industry, this virtual, ang dami na susulputan eh. We have an estimated around 10,000. That's my estimate. Rough estimate lang yon. I'm still not sure kasi may mga nagde-debut, may mga nag-graduate, may mga nag-retire, may mga nawawala na lang bigla, may mga naboboang. Oo. like this one. This is the fourth take of this episode, okay? The last time that we recorded this 1 month ago, wala pa si JM noon ano. I only had Sky and Kurt. And God, what are the developments after that? Hololive English, Manu Aloe, and recently, parang may nangyari yata sa, there's this local production. Sky, you'll tell more of us about that, ano, kasi nasa yung official statement ng mga kabaro mo. I hope you don't mind. So, bunta mo na
ikang,
tayo kay Ma.
Ika nga, Jay. Ika nga, Jay. This past four or five weeks of... in the VTuber universe, it's such a freaking roller coaster, and that is just Hololive. Hololive pa lang yan.
Wag ka, may mga balita rin ako tungkol sa mga grupo outside Hololive.
Oh God.
Oo. So yun ano? Okay, we'll start with JM. We'll start with Manu Aloe. Ang situation this, how I understood it is that Manu Aloe leaked a statement on her live 2D avatar, kung ano man yun. And this was leaked somewhere along October 2019 saying, screw idol culture. Kumbaga parang swan song ba niya yun? We can think of all the possibilities on how we can muster up or how we understand that stuff, right? Pero the ending, Manu Aloe, part of the fifth generation, graduated 2 weeks after she has debuted on her own volition. She was just suspended 2 weeks. And when I say under her own volition, it was her decision to graduate after that 2 week suspension time. Kasi nga hinahakas siya, she's being doxxed. Medyo naungkat yung balita as time comes by. People understood it initially as, oh, andyan na yung mga aunties. And then the story is flipped a few weeks after to say na no, Aloe was speaking on third person view about a retirement of a VTuber that she doxed. So hindi it's too overwhelming for us to understand in one go. JM, what are your thoughts on Manu Aloe?
I must admit it's kind of hard to say about what is happening because ano, because it's kind of a web of a situation na napakagulo. One thing I could definitely say that whatever it is, they should stop the harassment, they should stop anything because she's gone. One thing for sure is never gonna be forgotten. Last night nung nag-stream si Nene. Si Nene, she was mentioned. She was mentioned. She even sung Happy Synth. Kaya nga nakaka... And for a fact, Aloe's avatar still on Reddit is still in the Hololive thread. So I'm not sure when will they remove it, pero it's still there. But one thing I will say, it really hurts, lalo na yung mga Hololive fandom pa lang ako, pero I'm looking now into the outside right now. Pero as someone who's monitoring Hololive for the past 5 months, it kind of hurts deep kasi I could definitely see that Holo 5 is certainly close and they definitely have plans to do some stuff outside and inside, pero I think it's hard to say whatever happens, it kind of understand the pressure will come to her. Maybe it is also possible that her parents are saying something na medyo napahamak siya and maybe it would be better na dumistan siya kamuna, something like that. I would hope for the best for her talaga because I think she has a good potential. A lot of Hololive members are saying she's a good singer. Mm-mm. So sayang talaga eh. It's such a shame, but hopefully we could avenge that smile. Ika nga.
Avenge that smile. Yes, actually, yes. Right. Okay. So, Sky, your thoughts on Mano Aloe?
Actually, on Mano Aloe, not really much. Pero I can say na, what do you call this? Yung mga nangyari dito sa issue na to, it's because of, what do you call this? Dahil sa isang leak. And doon nagsimula talaga lahat. Pero all I can say is, ginawa nila na action to. Two-week suspension si Manuel Oe. Pero after 2 weeks, bigla natin nalaman na mag-graduate na pala siya. Yeah. And ang opinion ko dito is, parang pressure na dumadating talaga sa iyo. Especially, magdedebo ka palang SE VTuber sa isang malaking kumpanya na Hololive. Yun. Talagang tapos may issue ka agad. And I think hindi maganda yun sa magiging mental health mo. And talaga ang inisip ko. Buti lang, what they call this, inuna nila ang safety niyang, ng talent ni Mano Aloe. And I think, what they call this, medyo masabi ko lang talaga na mais yung ginawa nila ng decision. For Mano Aloe. Pero alam ko naman na si Mano Aloe herself, yung talent na mag-graduate doon sa grupo nila sa Gen 5. Yan yung pagkaalam ko. Can you confirm, Jay?
Yeah, she went on to decide to graduate from Hololive. After 2 weeks. So, yun, that's how I understood it. She made a mistake. Tapos, hindi lang siya yung, it takes two to tango kasi. She has her manager. We're not sure what happened to her manager. Either way. Kurt, what's your take on Mano Aloe? Yan, he's about
to be honest, yung stream na ginawa niyang apology stream or something. Mm-hmm. Yun yung nag-spark nun eh. Nagpalaki nun eh. Hindi yan malalaman. Better kung nanahimik na lang sila kesa nagsalita pa about dun. Kasi na ang hinayang ko lang talaga is yung yung singing niya. Ang ganda kasi talaga ng pagkakaboses niya. May ginagamit siyang effects or something, yes, which is kind of new sa Hololive. Kaya looking forward ako doon. Tapos bigla siyang nag-announce ng graduation. Kaya yun, nakakalungkot lang.
Oo. Masakit. Alright. So, perhaps the lesson here sa buong sitwasyon na to is nakita naman natin na there's many sides to the story. So, one, regardless kung magta-try ka lang ng 2D model or whatnot, even if it's allowed by your manager, kasi laissez-faire din naman ng mga manager, take it from me, I was practicing laissez-faire management and around 5 years ago and everything went downhill after that fast. So yun na nga, again, this is all about the character, the VTuber themselves. Actually, ayoko nga sabihin na they're VTubers kasi that term is dependent on YouTube eh. More on virtual characters. Niji Sanji has their term, virtual livers. So it can be something else,
Pero,
yes,
pero, Pero it really all boils down to that idol culture pa rin eh. Babalik pa rin talaga tayo dun sa idol culture na yun. Ganyan pa rin yung pagkaano nila sa pedestal na kailangan ganito yung standards.
Say-so ka talaga. Ganyan. Oo, kailangan say-so ka. And there's gatekeeping. Now, we'll talk about gatekeeping right now. Kasi, of course, the English-only please ngayon, with HoloLive English, we have Japanese-only please. So, the Japanese people who are watching HoloLive English now feels the same way.
Actually, same talaga. Kasi, whenever I see those ano what do you call this yung streams ng HoloLive EN, bigla may kita may Japanese translation dun sa live stream, like,
diba,
all
diba,
the tables have been turned,
the turns have
look table, how the turntables
the turns table have turns table. There you go.
Dami ng version na nga yun. Look how the turntables, ha?
Yeah, yo, can I just add a statement dun sa, ano, sa Manoy Aloy, ano? Ano,
yeah, Manoy Aloy. Yes, go.
Ano, talaga, may isa lang comment na dagdag. Ang masabi ko lang is, idol culture can be really scary, lalo na talaga sa Japan.
Really scary. Take it from us. We've seen MNL48. We've seen AKB48. We've seen Maho Yamaguchi. We've seen the likes of, sino ba yung idol na nag-ahit ng buhok niya as an apology? Yung nasa dulo ng dila ko yun eh. Pero, yeah. Those are the cases. You have to be say-so. So, kung hindi ka say-so, eh...
Sa... You can't remember yan eh.
Oo. Oh. So, yun nga. Back to gatekeeping. Some people would love to gatekeep this community kasi nagiging basura na daw di umano yung community natin and all that. And then there's the Filipinos who are commenting spams, cursing on the streams of VTubers. So, Kurt,
I'll start with you. Tagal na yan eh. Tagal na yan.
Kurt, what's your take on this?
May nakikita pa din ako.
Oo. Oh.
Mm, gatekeeping. It's a yes.
Yes.
Right. It's just why? That gatekeeping is a must.
Gatekeeping is a must.
Well, ayoko lang kasing makita ng mga cancelous na comments na irrelevant sa stream.
Oo.
Kahit sabihin natin, merong mga English-only speakers na nagko-comment. Meron din namang matino na magko-comment na related pa din sa stream. Hindi yung sasabihin mong, welcome to Brazil, welcome to this, or something.
Kulang na lang sabihin, come to Brazil.
Parati ako nakakita nyo ng come to Brazil na yan.
Okay,
meron din ano, tawag dito, meron din isang cases, or madami ko nang nakikita, na okay lang daw magsalita sa local language nila. Japanese people sila. Paano nila maintindihan yun? Kaya gusto ko sabihin, gatekeeping is a must.
The problem with that is yung nakalagay mismo dun sa rules kasi na as long as you follow the rules, you can speak in any language. So ngayon, medyo dun nagkakaroon nagkalituhan. Kaya problema, especially the Japanese YouTubers, they can only understand Japanese and they could barely understand standard English. So, medyo nagkakaroon
na. Make it easier for the streamer or do something. Don't chat at all. Kung ganun lang gagawin mo. Yun lang yung take ko.
Use your super chat to time wisely. Okay. Sky, your take on gatekeeping.
Medyo controversial kasi yung gatekeeping. Especially, alam mo naman yung nangyari dun sa yung Pokemon user, right?
Pokemon. you know, Pokemon just started that stream with that 2D model after HoloLive English. Buti, hindi sumakto na nagde-debut tong HoloLive English, sasabay siya doon sa, overlap siya doon. Because what happened to Russia when that happened? Lord, it was so sad.
Like, may kita mo talaga sa sa lahat ng profile pictures ng Facebook.
Oo.
Like, literally. And ginagamit, wala. Ginagamit nila yung profile picture na yan to represent a wrong community. Pero hindi naman talaga nire-represent. And doon, babanwagon mga normies. And sabihin nila, oy, gamitin mo tong profile picture na to. Yo. Kasi trending, ganun.
Trending, ganun. Oo. Mahilig tayo sumabay sa trend, eh.
Pero ito lang on take ko sa gatekeeping. Gatekeeping is fine, pero what do you call this? Pag, yung darating ka talaga sa the point wherein pipilitin mo yung iba na, what do you call this? Yung, ito. Yung gatekeeping, ha. May isang gatekeeping, pero not to the point na, okay, bawal kayo lahat dito.
dapat hindi ganun. And gatekeeping sa is okay talaga. Pero basta wag niyo lang yung okay, pipiliin niyo yung mga tao na pwede lang makapasok. Tapos ikaw bawal ka dito kasi ganito ka. No, bawal 'yan. Kaya as long as you respect the rules, respect kung yung ano, yung at yung ano, respect yung streamer, VTuber or ano, basta anyone ano, and understand the atmosphere, you should be fine from gatekeeping. Kaya masabi ko.
All right. Okay. Thank you for that,
guys. Tanong ko din, Jay. Are we talking about dun sa mga katulad ng issue na kay katulad kay Pokemon today?
We're talking about that as well. Kasi it takes a group of people, di ba? For example, fans ni Pokemon, they're said to be notorious. Lacks respect. Di umano. And so if they fall into the VTuber community, para tayong magiging reception yan. So we hold the gates, tayo yung opisina, para tayong security guards na. Of course, we have to protect the smiles of all these VTubers, regardless kung Hololive ni Jisanji, independent, univirtuals, or even si Lyrica, or si, ano ba to? Si Nova, or something like that. You know, yun nga eh, kumbaga parang it takes two to tango. The VTuber, the streamer, and then the people, the fans who are watching her. So it takes two to tango to have a conversation, to have a healthy discussion, to have something worthwhile, worthy. And maraming mga gigs, ano ba to? Maraming mga discard itong mga VTubers na to. Last time, on Lyrica's channel, she was doing an ASMR reading of Aba, Nakakabasa na Pala Ako by Bob Ong. Nakarelate kami doon. And that was a wholesome stream that made me send another super chat. So, super chat to time.
Sana all may ayuda, no? Pang super chat.
Kung si 50 lang ang bigay mo na super chat, I think that's fine. 50 pesos lang, you can ask a question, may bayad ang tanong.
Instead of bumili ng ice cream na 20 pesos, pang super chat na rin.
Hanggang saan alabot ang 50 pesos mo?
Not sponsored.
So yeah, we now move on to Hololive. Yes, JM.
Hindi po pa ako natatanong nung hold dito. With regards naman sa gatekeeping, I would, kung ako ang tatanungin mo, I could understand naman kung why do people feel that way. Mm-hmm. Pero I kind of experienced this with the anime culture, the anime thing. I have some doubt na if you ask me, I kind of don't want to have some gatekeeping kasi it kind of defeats the purpose na you want to show the world na this is
the culture. Who they are.
This is the culture. Mm-hmm. Parang ikaw nga parang tingnan mo na nga lang yung mga VTubers sa Facebook eh. Parating nilang sinasabi, bakit ganyan yung Reddit, puro ganyan. But the problem is they're basing Reddit on R. Donald and all other political stuff na nandiyan. Pero pag ang nakakalimutan nila, Reddit is composed of several subreddits na they have their own rules, they have their own guidelines. And kung titingnan mo naman yung R Hololive, it is filled with good people. It is
good memes.
Good memes. Yeah. Good memes. Madaming
good memes at piskoko.
Madaming Lamy Flu.
Lamy Flu.
and then people know how to maintain it. People respect the rules. Pag meron sila nakikitang nagsumasabat ng kung ano, they all voted it down. Kaya nga parang if we prevented people na makita discover, keep it into something of a niche, parang it kind of defeats the purpose na gusto mo na makita to ng gusto. It would be something na you would be proud of. It would be something na it should be shared kasi nga ang daming ang gandang bagay na nakikita mo sa mga bagay-bagay na ano na tulad ng the culture. Mm-hmm. I kind of wish though na medyo hinay-hinay lang sa mga chat. Yun yung nakakairita. Ako rin naman nakairita.
Lalo or you can, follow this rule na you open notepad, ipatong mo yung notepad doon sa chat window. Tapos yeah, lagay mo, well, sweet chat yo mo, kawaii. Yun lang yung nakalagay dun sa text. That's it.
kung ako kasi yung inaano mo, hindi ko matiis. Kailangan talaga. Report yung mga ungas na yan.
Eh, sa akin naman eh, either ano eh, iba, there are many ano eh, there are schools of thought regarding chat. Schools of thought. Okay. So, yeah. You either block, you de-ignore, you either report. Ayan, you block it your own or you report it to YouTube or to the mods. I guess we have only 9 minutes on the first part. So, we'll do a quick round of stuff ano. Okay. So, Hololive English. Hololive English talaga. So, since Hololive English has debuted, it really, really, really went up. Yun nga, the tables have turned, the turns have tabled, the tables have turns, and those who turned are the tables. So, So, okay, so we have 5 ladies here. 5 ladies. We have Kiara, who is the businesswoman. A Phoenix businesswoman yan. Phoenix idol fan businesswoman rather, no, who wants to have her own fight fast empire. I invested in I pitched in the barest minimum of stonks on her IPO last time. Nag IPO siya, ladies and gentlemen. And we have Ninomai Inanis. Ang parang sa pakinggan ng pangalan niya, no, sasabi mo Inanis. This the taco time VTuber, very comfy. It's kumbaga kung pwede niyang i-guest si Lily Picho. I'm saying it, if she can guest Lily Picho on her stream and they can do a draw stream together, that will be the most comfiest thing I will ever watch. Okay. We also have Mori Calliope. Mori Calliope spits beats, spits curses, slays people with the beach, and then after 2 songs, finally, may kanta na galing sa kanya na I can share with the rest without saying na, be warned, the explicit content to. Kasi rap culture naman yan eh. Rap culture. We also have...
Ang sabi rin niya, she was inspired with the past Japanese rap.
Mm-hmm.
Which is kind of surprisingly nice.
Ay, di ba? Kumbaga wordplay yun eh. I love it when you talk about wordplay. Now, I want a flip-top stream with Mori Calliope and someone else. Regardless, flip-top. There's rap battles all over the world. Flip-top is included there. So,
top 10 rappers Eminem scared off.
What the fuck?
Top 10 rappers Eminem. Oh, that made me listen to Logic and Eminem's Homicide. Oh, of course, that's filled with expletives. Also, that made me listen to Eminem's latest Godzilla track with Juice WRLD, the late Juice WRLD. No, ang galing pa rin ni Eminem when it comes to those things. Now, moving forward, we also have si Gargora. Gargora. I'll say her name fast. Gargora. City Pop Shark, who apparently is the ones running the whole Hololive English table when it comes to super chats. So yun ano.
And the most of the subscribers for just about 4 days, nakaabot na siya ng 300+.
300,000.
300,000+.
Yun yung malupit eh. And lastly, we have Holmes. I was supposed to say Hachama Holmes. Wee!
Ay, hintay mo na lang kapag sumigaw siya ng
ah!
Ng character.
I've actually watched her Valorant stream all of a sudden. Parang natutulog lang ako. I was the YouTube's playing her Valorant stream beside me. So parang okay. And sabi nga ng mga comments, hindi siya iniiwanan ng tao basta-basta kahit matalo siya, because she's good at commentating. She's good at commentating stuff. So that's Hololive English. Now, before everything else, we will be taking a quick break and then we'll go back to everyone with of you to ask questions about Hololive English and more of the VTubers on this special episode.
International Podcast Day is September 30th, and you can help spread the word. You may be asking, what can I do to get involved? It's pretty simple. Head over to internationalpodcastday.com and check the suggestions. Then use hashtag International Podcast Day to join the conversation. You can reach out and connect with other podcasters, listeners, and your favorite podcast hosts. Remember September 30th, International Podcast Day, a day-long celebration of the power of podcasts.
And we're back. Thank you for continuing to listening and watching through this podcast. And we're now on the second part of our show. So, kanina, we're still talking about Hololive English. And may dadagdag pa ako doon eh. Have I not mentioned that Kiara Takanashi is one of... Kiara Takanashi is her character designer, her Popeye's Huke of the Black Rock Shooter fame. So, imagine that. And also, we also have...
pero siya rin yung matinding troll doon sa mga stream ni
Yun, yun yung malupit. And ito, have I not mentioned yet yung papa ni Inanis, ni Ina, si Kohaku Kuroboshi, also popular for his works on Kino no Tabi, Kino's Journey. And I love Kino's Journey.
Me too. Yep.
Great minds think alike. Okay. So, all right. Where was I? Ayan, Hololive English. So, before this Hololive English thing...
Yes, go, JM. No, okay. Continue.
Sige. Before this Hololive English thing, we've realized the effect of Asakoko in our lives. Nobody, again, inuulit ko, nobody has ever tried to stream at 6 in the morning Japan time about a morning show that's all about VTubers within the Hololive circle and yung mga kusozako news nila. Nobody but Asakoko. And that alone, aside from Koko being bilingual, that escalated further. I asked, kasi it happened to me, that escalated further my interest in VTubers. How about sa inyo? Let's start with JM.
Asako. I, for one, I'm very happy that it is back. Kasi medyo, I'm kind of lacking that Asakoko concoction thing. Uh-oh. Medyo, ayoko masobran sa Watson concoction.
Watson's concoction.
Grabing acid trip yun. Ano pa yan? Kailangan ko, ika nga sinasabi ko, kailangan ko ng Lamiplu para lang anuhin yun. Anyways, it's really good that the EN is focusing on the US crowd, kasi of course ang daming audience ng Hololive, pero they're mostly basing it on through the clips, the translated clips. So it would be nice na talaga merong organic reach na they are supporting, they know how to support, they know what they are supporting. Like what saying Hololive English na talagang medyo they kind of know how they can understand what is happening, so yun. But ang downside lang talaga, it's in a stream is freaking 5 a.m. or so, kaya oh my god, I want to watch.
Good morning
Asakoko. Starting tomorrow. Woo!
Although Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays lang yung Asakoko, pero it's great to be back. Kasi, of course, at the end of the day, Asakoko gets subtitles na prepared by the Asakoko team themselves, which is basically Kirikoko. No? Right, Kurt.
And Watame.
Watame. Oo, si Watame. Oo. Watame. Kaya nga power, yung powerhouse na yun. Oo. Kurt, do you think the rise... the expansion of Asakoko's distribution contributed to how Hololive English is accepted?
To be honest, si Koko naman talaga yung nag-trigger sa tingin ko. Mm-mm. Ng EN.
So yun, malupit din eh. Yes, right.
Ang dami ding nahatak ni Koko. Ang dami ding nahatak ni Koko. English viewer. Mm-hmm. Because that as Koko, the playing gun dealer.
Dealer talaga. It's really a deal breaker din, ano? Kasi again, 6 in the morning, then good morning, expletives. Ana, Sky, what's your take on Asakoko's contribution to the VTubing community?
Alright, let's start dun sa Asakoko. It all started dun sa isang clip na sinabi niya, good morning, I don't want to say the word.
Yung sinabi yung word niya. And nag-spread, and there we go, nagkaroon ng English subtitles yung Asakoko. And dun nagsimula talaga yung pagka-attract ng mga, what do you call this, foreign fans instead of Japanese.
Mm-mm. And if I'm not mistaken, kasi, it's not just the fans who got attracted to that Asakoko, sweet, sweet Asakoko. It's also the people who want to be like her. So, dumami yung mga virtual YouTubers and then nag-expand and then lately ko lang na-realize yung this group called Univirtuals. Mia Kimino was leading the ring of international VTubers. Loose org sila. There's no formal org, pero they come if you believe in their cause, you can be part of that group. Parang just let Mia Kimino know, Hanjo TV basically. Kasama dyan si Kahero, si Kahero ng Pilipinas, yung
Kahero. Yes.
Si Kahero Orange. Kahel has just reached 20,000 subscribers. Congratulations sa kanya.
Right. Anyways, sabi ko lang din sa Koko, yung alam yung tipong matutulog ka na at 4 a.m. tapos nalaman mo, nga pala may Asakoko.
Magigising ka lang biglaan. So, walang tulog, tara na.
Walang tulog. No sleep, gang. Ay.
Yeah, kasi 6 a.m. sa Japan. Pag 6 a.m. sa Japan, 5 a.m. dito sa Pilipinas.
Oo.
Wala na tulogan, sir. Ganyan na po.
Ang problema pa, yung mga unarchived karaoke, ay, sus naman.
Yeah, I can feel you that. Pero pag a member ka, I think ma-access mo naman.
Well, meron ba? Parang wala. Talaga, I think, ha?
Huh? Membership, meron? Wala, let me check.
Sino sa inyo member ng Asakoko, ng Kiryokai?
Kiryokai.
Okay. I think I lost the connection with
Actually, wala pala. Chinek ko lang yung yung membership ngayon. Wala pala. Never mind.
Talagang...
I can talaga.
Jibaiting me, ah. You're jibaiting me, Sky. Jibait ka.
Sorry.
Pero before mamaya, kasi alam ko sa mga ibang VTubers, pagka naging member ka, you'll get access sa mga ibang, what they call this, yung members only, videos and streams.
Oh, meron talaga mga members only. I think si nung nagkaroon ng membership si Botan, nagkaroon din siya ng isang nagkaroon na siya ng members only stream just a few days ago. Member ako din ni Botan. So I'm
so botanist ka. Botanist ka.
Botanist
ka. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, JM Melegrito Anime Pilipinas, isa pong botanist. Botanist ni Botan. There's a study, field of study kasi called botany. Mga halaman. Alright.
Pwede ba yung ba nga yung icon niya, yung halaman din?
O nga, she's very calm. Very calm. Yun yung masasabi ko sa kanya. Well, alright, okay. Since nasobra na tayo sa Asakoko, let's get another topic here. We have here ni Jisanji. Kurt is an expert on this. He mentioned earlier...
No, I'm not.
Oy, parang ikaw ang nilalapitan ko pagdating sa Niji, ha? Sige. You introduced me to this family called Dokuzohon siya. This was supposed to be a company, pero close family ties prevailed. And I watched one of their lives, 3D lives, 3D music lives. That was a plethora, a smorgasbord, if I may say, of good music. Naalala ko when Kamen Rider Hibiki was being aired on 5, yung second theme song nila, that was the bomb eh. That was yung tenor na yon, yung kung sino mo kumakata yon. Nung kinanta yun, I was like, my God. Sino ali yan? Si siya, ba?
Kisuko,
okay.
Yashiro?
Oo. Si Yashiro, oo. So, yun nga, di ba? Really, I never expected that. Tapos ano pang unexpected na ano. Pero hindi talaga di ko makakalimutan yung Hibiki eh. That was good.
Yung unexpected dun is yung collab ni Kusuka. tsaka ni Dola Mama. Oo. Kasi hindi ko sila nakikitang magkasama. Mm. Na silang dalawa lang talaga. Mm-hmm. Kasi parang if we're talking off-cam, parang acquaintance lang talaga sila. Yung parang lagi kong naririnig sa ano sa kanila na sinasabi nila. Parang ang awkward nila tignan pag silang dalawa lang. Kaya yun, nagulat ako nung mayroong part na ganun.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of Dola Mama, she's good. Kumbaga, she's open. She opened yung... There was this one stream that I enjoyed. Yung nagle-layout siya ng OBS. Of course, most if not all VTubers do their layouts on OBS, the open broadcast software, no? Eh, napa-super chat ako ng hindi oras. Nahiya ako. well, I'm basically saying thank you for sharing the behind the scenes to look at what at how VTubers do their thing, do their layouting things sa OBS. And parang, of course, I'm English only plebeian.
EOP.
Hindi ka pala nag-credit eh. Ano kaya ako? That was fun. And of course, Honhima. Sino hindi makakakita kay, ano, sino hindi makakakilala kay Honhima sa buong ni Gisanji? She's like one of the popular people there eh. Aside from Kinomito. Aside from Gibara.
Gorilla.
Never forget her IMAS gacha stream. Ah. Nabaliw siya. Nabuang talaga si Tonchun. Nabuang
siya. Seryoso.
Oh, mag-gacha ka pa naman eh.
Ilan yung nagastos niya dun? Nakalimutan ko.
Pero 10,000 yen figure yata yun eh. 5 figures yata yun eh.
5 figure yun eh.
5 figure yun eh.
50k yen ata. 50k yen.
Oo,
yung nagastos niya.
Lupit eh.
Tapos hindi niya tinatanako, ha?
Oo. Ayan. Tapos meron pa ako nakita dito isang malaking, ano, isang malaking mahiwaga to that she can maintain her voice singing the same song 100 times in one stream. That took her 4, 5, 3, 4, 5
Ima.
Hours. Machita? Chima, ano ba? Tama ba?
Eight hours ata.
Chimachita.
Machita chima.
Machita chima. Ayan. Chimachita. Ang ayan, ito yung mga pangalan na katulad ni Yui Gahama tapos ni ano, Yukinoshita. Tapos na
Yanaginagi.
Oh. Oh. Yanaginagi tapos na Rasagawa. Yan. So pandagdag na naman sa
yung nag super chat pati si Aqua.
Singing the Frieza 100 times.
101 to be exact.
101?
Diba, I was there 2 hours. For 2 hours. Tapos, why am I doing this to myself? Paulit-ulit na lang. Ang, ano, hanggang 30 songs hanggang 69. Sa 69 talaga ako huminto eh. Kasi yun ang lucky number.
Nice.
Nice.
Ayan. So, okay. Since nakapokus tayo kay Kurt, we'll ask the other ones to mention kung sino bang nakikilala nila, kung sino bang gusto nila, trip nila sa Nigisanji. Because this is a big virtual liver group. Mas malaki pa ito sa HoloLive in terms of numbers. In terms of virtual livers, they have in Indonesia.
100 plus,
diba? Including Indonesia, Korea, and yung Indian na na-convert to Nijisanji English.
E-N.
This was before HoloLive English, ha?
Mm-mm.
This was under, ano, underviewed. Hindi ito masyadong pansinin. So, yeah. Sky, Nijisanji. Mention anyone from Nijisanji.
Ars Almal.
Okay. Kurt, masasabi mo, ang sabi, ano? Sabi niya Ars Almal. What do you say that? Ars Almal, Kurt.
Wala mo siya masasabi.
Mal.
Big face. Si Ars.
Big face, yun lang.
Damn.
I'm starting to delve with Nijisanji.
Pero, bumalik na siya sa ano?
Saan, Kurt? Sige, ikaw muna.
Sa ano, bumalik na siya sa pag-stream niya ng late night Minecraft na umaabot ng ano umaga.
Whoa!
Yun lang. Parang
what is
1 a.m. hanggang 8 a.m. Nag-i-stream siya.
Parang tayo lang yan, ha? Parang pilitan lang tayo yan, ha? Sige, JM, back to you. Back to you.
Disclaimer lang, I'm just starting with the Nijisanji. Actually, Nijijanji yung nasasabi ko minsan.
Nijijanji.
Pero medyo napa-side third kasi ako doon sa mga indie YouTubers eh. Like, Lyrica.
Ah, si Lyrica o si Lola o.
Si Lola o. Pero, I'm... Of course, ang nako-curious muna ako is yung mga popular ones. Debbie.
Debbie. Ay, oh, Debbie.
Debbie, well.
Oh, Debbie.
Debbie.
Imagine. Debbie. Na nakapatong ka lang sa lap. On the lap. You're just on the lap of your colleagues. Lord.
And I say, sana ako na lang siya. Sana ako na lang siya.
Sana all.
Yung tipong close pa sila si Coron. Wow, ha? Mm. Nung 3D. Sit on your lap. Wow.
Yes. Ayun, no? So, meron pa eh. Si Debbie pa lang ba mame-mention mo?
Debbie at saka si, ano, si Edra. Si, yung, ano, ah, yung, si, art, si student, yung art student. Yung art student. Yung
si Conlulu o si Suzuhara Lulu. I still remember this virtual liver by the name of Takamiya Rion na she's a diehard Kirito fan. Husband niya si Kirito.
Don't start her with that. Okay? Huwag mo siyang umpisahan.
And if we talk about Asuna in front of her, she was like, sino siya?
Non-existent yun.
Non-existent.
Shadow yung waifu niya eh. So yun daw yung waifu ni Kirito eh.
Go talk to Kawahara, Reki. Pero that was amazing. I lost that video. Hindi ko siya mahanap these days. Pero that was fun. Seeing na, kumbaga, a drawing ni Kirito, yung original illustration, tapos katabi niya. That was fantastic. That was something. And then pinatong pa niya doon sa live stream niya. Di ba? You saw it. Let's not mention, Gibara. Let's not forget to mention, Gibara, super chat. Gibara,
host. Gorilla. Gorilla super chat.
Animal spirit talaga.
Ayan, no? So that's Nijisanji to you, everyone. Ano? So let's not just forget Nijisanji. Again, sa Nijisanji Day in Indonesia, dumadabi din sila. Si Tito Bonnie, I call him Tito Bonnie. Kasi he's Indonesian but he has been to Cebu before. So he knows, he understands Bisaya. Right? It's in his tweets. Tapos may tagurumin pa siya. And again, I've been saying this again and again. In my past vlogs, etc., Philippines and Indonesia are parallel countries. The only difference is faith. I tell you.
And sometimes language, ah.
And yes.
Pero meron lang ibang understanding ang Malaysia, Indonesia, Singapore sa language natin. But yeah, we're like Spain and Portugal.
Oo. Spain and Portugal talaga tayo. Ayan, so yes, basically Malay. Ano pa ba? Si ano? Forget it. Ang back to Hololive Indonesia, ang talagang pinaka ano, if you were to ask me kung sino talaga in every VTubers pinakapipiliin ko, ayun Darisu. The squirrel. So, you have a combination of a comfy squirrel, a mischievous squirrel, and a DLC. A bloody DLC that makes you question life. Alright?
Kala ko naman, haha, zombies ko, brrr.
Kala ko yun.
Di pa yun. Oh, that's one thing. But yung DLC niya, DLC. You search Ayunda Rizzo DLC and you'll see why. Right. So, back to Nijisan.
As long as you don't let her count Muna's piggy bank.
Yes.
That was an talaga, epic video.
I'm in danger.
You're talking about Alter Rizzo.
I was Alter Rizzo and the coin bank. The coin bank.
I'm so, okay. I'm not okay.
I'm not okay. I feel threatened.
So yung tapos yung ano, na-recruit tayo ni Rizzo. Na-recruit tayo ni Rizzo. Remember that?
No.
Butala hindi mo napansin.
Oo. Mas focus sa coin bank and dun sa DLC. So, ayan. I still have her in my wallpaper sa cellphone. No? So, yeah, that's Hololive ni Gisanji for you. Pero let's focus on the local side. We have Kahiro and we have Lyrica based in Canada. Ito si Lyrica to, sabi ko nga, di ba, ang malakas ang trip nito eh. This is not the second time that she amazed me. It made me go super chat and all. The first one that she did was a reading, live reading ng Noli Metangere in its original language. Na Spanish, mix of Spanish Filipino, wala pang letter K noon. It's letter C. So pinabasa niya lahat ng mga ano, mga pinili niya sa Discord server nila, and it was that was really something else, ano. That kind of audience participation, hindi ko nakita yon sa the rest of the people except kay Lyrica. Mind you. So you go watch Lyrica, you go to Lyrica's channel. Amazing. All right. So
I'm definitely more entertained. Yes, sa tweets, yes, diba? Lalo na sa mga interaction niya with the Hololive Indonesia team.
Yes. Yes. You're amazing. Eh. You're an independent VTuber based in Canada, and yet you are able to talk with Hololive Indonesia. God, what an achievement.
Yung tipong sinasabihan daw siya ni Muna na ano, na
sali ka na dito, siya. Sali ka na dito. Basically, taga-Pilipinas ako, di ba?
I think that's a big na she's doing very well. She's doing very well as a VTuber.
Yes.
I guess ang problema na lang talaga siguro kay Lyrica is medyo she's stuck in the 2010s sex bomb dancers.
Kaya ang tawag sa kanya yung Lola. That is her advantage.
Boomer VTuber.
Boomer eh. Boomer talaga, 69 years old. 69 years old.
Thanks. Eh, pero at least kinanta niya siniskwela, no?
Wow. Yes.
Yeah, hindi, I guess he never. Narinig niya ba?
Di pa.
Yeah. Okay, all right.
Somewhere. Send links.
Yeah, sure.
All right. Okay, so we're just down to our 13 minutes of this episode. Ano? Pero, of course, hindi natin makakalimutan, may mga issues din locally. It really affected the recording of this episode. Mawalang galang na po sa kay Sky kasi he's with the Deep Sea Productions and he's not going to speak for himself on the situation that they had kasi let's say ulitin mo lang yung statement ng Deep Sea, mga kabaro mo sa Deep Sea. Sky, please.
Hold on. Regarding about Deep Sea, medyo limited lang talaga ang pwede ko masabi dito. Yes. Pero let me just restate yung sinabi ng Deep Sea about this. Mm-hmm. So basically, nagkaroon ng problema doon sa loob ng ng team, tapos nagkaroon ng conflict. Mm-hmm. Regarding about doon sa talents, tapos sa mga higher-ups, and pero nagkaroon naman na kami ng agreement. Nagkaroon kami sa agreement sa both sides. Tapos what I call this? Yeah, yung sudden news bigang nakalat, and yung statement dito ay ito, number one, ika-cancel yung productions, yung debut, tapos yung mga streaming schedules. And yung tatlong maka-cancel. So basically, parang officially graduated na yung mga talents. Deep Sea Productions. And ang mangyayari is, what I call this, marirebrand yung Deep Sea. Hindi na magiging Deep Sea ang pangalan niya. And what I call this, magkakaroon ng bagong bagong team, ganun.
Okay. Alright.
Pero so, ano, for now, ang masasabi ko lang dito is, what do you call this? Anyway, let me clarify lang doon sa mga ano. Ang daming rumors flying around, lang doon sa isang Reddit post na nakikita ko.
Yes.
Yung ano, din na post sa page. Ang masasabi ko lang doon, number one, safe na safe ang ano, ang mga talents namin. Sinabi na yun ng ano, ng isang harap namin na, what do you call this? Na ano, ano yung classified talaga yung information na yun. Dalawa lang nakakalaman. And,
there's no doctor.
Ano, what do you call? Halos wala talaga nakakalaman. Kaya napaka-safe ng information regarding about dun sa talents. Number two, what do you call this? Ano, both agreements dun sa dalawang parties. Sila mismo ang nag-agree na mag-step down. And what I call this, pumayag sila sa decision na mangyayari dito sa team na to. Mm-hmm. And ito lang talaga masasabi ko.
Okay.
Video editor lang ako. Wala masyado nangyari behind the scenes, yes, talaga. Seryo. Mm-hmm. What I call this, nagkaroon kami ng miscommunication talaga. Mm-hmm. You know, katulad din sinabi dun sa Deepsea, ano, mm-hmm, dito sa page na to. There's some miscommunications, misunderstanding happening inside the production team. Kaya ano, gulat na gulat talaga ako nung yung nakita ko.
I think ako pa yung nagpakita sa'yo nitong ano eh, nung update. Sabi ko, what's happening?
And this happened nung what I call this after pa ng birthday ko. And
yun lang. Oh,
sila, iniisip ko talaga na ano, na hindi, sarili hindi masama. Gusto ko lang talaga nga na maayos to eh. Pero, guess I was wrong.
Well,
within the span of 2 days na nawala na.
Din talaga ako na-shock eh.
Wala akong masyadong ibang sasabihin ah. Sinabi ko lang yung nasa loob ng what I call this, yung pay, yung ano, nung statement. Wala na akong ibang sasabihin dito kasi in order to protect yung ano, yung talagang nangyayari. Anyways.
And also in order to protect yourself. Now, the reason why I ask listeners and viewers, the reason why I ask Sky to mention this, he's part of Deepsea but he's not on the higher ups. No? Deepsea Productions is a local production, and then there's one of their talents expressed on Twitter na she's out of this kasi there's hindi sila nakikita-kita and there is no formal structure na this is a production. So that statement earlier na sinabi ni Sky na upon realizing that na ganun, it affected 1, 2, 3, 4 talents nila. Tatlong magde-debut, tapos isang ano, tama ano, tatlong magde-debut, isang currently on us, and that is also a vampire. And kumbaga in Southeast Asia, the name is Lilith. She also interacted with Liliana Vampire of My Holo TV in Malaysia. So you see, although malaki, it's great to expand to your beyond your territory. Again, VTubers are a fast-paced industry. If you can say that yourself, no. And there's this also yung mga general na mga pahaging ng mga mas nauna pa sa kanila na mas sumikat kayo pero kami pinaghirapan pa namin to with blood, sweat and tears. Parang ganun yung parang ano, implying na hindi, kumbaga parang it's unfair, which is the world is unfair and these things do happen. It's just sad that na as one of us viewers nangyari to sa atin. So we'll close that for now ano kasi hindi pa matatapos yung usapan na yan. I'll go back to Kurt and JM to share their final thoughts on VTubers as a whole. What do they see? Outlook nila? Mabilisan lang. JM?
I think I definitely see something bright with VTubing. Hindi yung mga pinagsasabi ng mga ibang mga haters dyan na it's a HoloLive English launch. It'll be the end of VTubing. No, I think it's something gonna be well kasi I think all companies are now being proactive sa mga nangyayari. They have now their own report pages. They are now protecting their talent. So I think it will be I'll see something much better content. Nagpapa-contest din si Mori. So I'm one day pa lang, I can see a lot of great remixes na napapanggay. So, content-wise, corporate-wise, everything, I think I would definitely see something bright with VTubing.
I'm looking forward to the second class that I will attend sa channel ni Kiara about business. Kasi di ba, ang dami, may mga nag-design ng menu talaga, literally, figuratively. And those were parang, yun yung ano, kumbaga parang mga layout artists yun, Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Oo, open for hiring yung mga yun, to be quite honest. Kurt, what do you see about VTubers in the future? Pabilisan lang.
Ano? Tawag dito? Same as usual. Katulad ng sinabi ni JM, it's looking good. Excited lang ako sino yung magiging future Oshi ko. Sino yung ipapalo ko? At ano yung magiging content nila?
Alright. Okay. Thank you, Kurt. Sky, final thoughts.
Final thoughts on VTubing. Masabi ko talaga to. Ito na talaga yung mangyayari. This is what's happening right now. Kasi we're on, hindi naman sa, dahil sa quarantine, na talaga it's becoming more of a, ano, nabit-eating now. Talagang, alam mong, regardless, hindi talaga mapipreventa yung mga, ano eh, what they call this, yung mga magbabanwago, mag-nermis. No, it's fine lang. Hayaan na yan. Ano, lalaki naman talaga eh. So that's expected. So eh, pero ang pros naman nito, marami tayong makikitang content, yung katulad ng sinabi, remixes, songs, yung mga stream ideas and
mga live reading, mga live Tetris battles, ni Lyrica, ayun, mga ganon. Yes.
Indeed. Pero ano, alam mo ba yung sinabi ko ng recording about sa VTubing nung nakita ko to, like pag-gising ko pa lang, lahat na sila VTuber. Ha? Ba? Ha? Mga VTuber na yung mga kasama.
Actually, yes.
Pag-gising ko pa lang, ha? Eh, di ako magiging VTuber. Bala kayo dyan.
And, ayun. So, I guess that sums up everything na ano, on this special episode. Thank you very much, everyone, for being part of this. And again, may collab kami ni Sky na we'll do this thing called Balitang Vay. As in VTubers.
Yeah, still designing on the name though.
Oo. We're still, pero tentative yun. Pero I'm suggesting Balitang Vay. Para naman, it's Vay! Parang ganun lang. Ayan. So, again, JM Melegrito, animepilipinas.com. Kurumeme, he's on YouTube. Just search for his name and find his clips of Dokuzohon siya. Translated and Sky has his own YouTube channel, Sky-desu. So with that said, again, episode 81, happy birthday to me. Lord, salamat po sa panibagong taon na buhay pa tayo at malakas at nagagawa pa rin natin ang nagagawa natin. Maraming salamat sa hanap buhay at maraming salamat sa hobby na nagbubuhay sa atin. Ladies and gentlemen, this wraps up the podcast. Stay safe.
Ikambokam!
Ikambokam.
That wraps up another episode of Keepsakes, the podcast. New episodes can be heard at anchor.fm/keepsakes, Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, and Spotify. Don't forget to visit me on social media for updates. Facebook.com/keepsakesbyj, Twitter @jagonoy, youtube.com/jagonoy, and my blog at jagonoy.xyz. I hope you enjoyed listening to this podcast. Until next time.